Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Keith, and welcome to my review of the new film, Sorry to Bother You. This is the new film from filmmaker and rapper Boots Riley. Now, this is an interesting undertaking because here's somebody who didn't just jump into making a film. He went through the Sundance Film Festival Writers Program and really took his time with his script, and now he's brought to the screen a pretty interesting film. The film stars Lakeith Stanfield, who many of you will recall from the movie Get Out. He's the guy who was basically abducted at the beginning of that film. In this film, he plays Cassius, and Cassius is working at a telemarketing firm. The interesting thing is that he is trying to get ahead, he is trying to do well, but he's not making a lot of sales because his black voice isn't going over well with customers. He's told by his senior rep on the floor to start using his white voice, and by doing so, the sales will come. And he turns on this whole different persona, and the next thing you know, the sales are definitely coming. They call this a futuristic type of film. They call it a science fiction type of film. I call it a very smart film. It's very interesting how this film really delves into the exploration of race relations in the States. I can say I have had telemarketing type jobs before, and I will admit there have been times where I've spoken to customers and then they see my picture and then they think, okay, well, I'm dealing with something completely different, and the tones change. True story. So there was a lot about this movie I found very relatable. But on top of that, there are a lot of other interesting things and dynamics that go on in this film that I don't want to give away. What I can say after watching this is that it's a very different type of film, but I enjoyed that. I enjoyed the originality that Boots Riley has put together on the screen. And for a first-time filmmaker, this guy didn't shortchange in terms of getting stars. In addition to Lakeith Stanfield and his love interest played by Tessa Thompson, Danny Glover makes an appearance. We've got Rosario Dawson is in this film, Patton Oswalt. A pretty good lineup of actors and actresses in this movie. So I was very impressed with that. I also think this movie does a lot to open up discussion in terms of not only race relations, but just in terms of looking at the overall view of how we treat each other in terms of society. I really like this film, but I appreciate the fact that there are going to be some people, I can think of a couple of people that I know, that are a little conservative and this movie won't resonate with. And that's okay. Not every single movie is made for everyone, and not every single movie will be accepted by everyone. And that's cool. This movie was very well accepted by me. I thought it was done extremely well. This is not a big budget movie by any stretch of the imagination, but what it lacks in the big budget, it totally makes up for in dialogue and in terms of original filmmaking. So I congratulate Boots Riley on a job well done. I'm looking forward to seeing what he does next. I give this movie a B+. I really enjoyed it, and I think the open-minded individual will as well. If you get a chance to see Sorry to Bother You, let me know what you think. CFL_fan on Twitter, facebook.com/wittywittier, and wittywittier.com. Thank you so much for checking this out. My name is Keith, and I'll see you at the movies.